The Uganda Railway Corporation has once again resumed the eviction of people occupying the Uganda Railway Corporation land so as to pave way for the rehabilitation and expansion of the railway line. The ongoing eviction started today in Kireka, where part of Kireka Farmers Market was demolished. The affected are vendors who had put up temporary structures and stalls along the railway line. The officials proceeded to Kasenyi Zone in Banda, Nakawa Division. Here, dozens of houses were demolished. Amidst tight security, the tractors raised down all houses within 30 meters from the railway line as the owners helplessly looked on. Residents say they were not notified of the eviction.
This is too much on us. Why evict us now when we have just taken back our children to school? We even have lawns. Now we don't have homes. Where shall we go? Why evict us without any compensation? Where shall we go? All our things have been destroyed. How shall we live?
They claim they had even petitioned the president to intervene in their matter and compel the Uganda Railway Corporation to compensate them, but they did not get any response. The father said that they tried to engage Uganda Railway Corporation to compensate them, but their plea was ignored.
I heard over the news that Parliament had directed the Uganda Railway Corporation to get us some little money to help us relocate to other places. But now see, where shall we go without anything? This is unfair.
According to John Sengendo, the Uganda Railway Corporation spokesperson, over 2,000 are to be affected by the ongoing eviction. However, efforts are underway to compensate them by the end of the year.
The Uganda Railway Corporation are still compiling the lists, and very soon all the affected persons will be compensated. We ask for their patience as we continue rehabilitating the railway line.
Early this year, the government of Uganda commenced the rehabilitation of the Uganda railway line, replacing the over a century-old steel sleepers with concrete ones. Story by Rachel Nachwala for the news.